Hi, my name is Eric Fossi. I am a local Calgary illustrator. I specialize in doing mostly mammals and bird fauna of local to Alberta. I was contacted by the Royal Tyrrell Museum in late 2019 to complete this huge task of 84 illustrations over about a 5 or 6 month period. And I absolutely said yes. I'm a huge fan of the museum. I grew up in Alberta. I loved coming to the museum when I was much younger. I never really thought about mammals. I mean, I think most people always think about dinosaurs when they come to the museum, but I was so honored to be picked for this and to see it all come together, see all the illustrations and how the team has put them together is just phenomenal. So here are a few of the tools that I used to make all of the paintings and illustrations. Aside from a pencil, obviously, to start the sketches, but everything is then inked using this calligraphy brush pen. And it's the difference between this and a regular pen is basically, instead of having like a little nib on the end, it's actually got a paintbrush bristle that you might be able to see there. As I push my finger on it, it actually splays apart. So they're all individual nylon hairs on that. And what that allows is for you to basically vary the line width as you're drawing. It creates a more sort of expressive line. It's great for drawing fur and animals. And then here is all the watercolors that I use. And I built this palette based on the project. I wanted very high transparency watercolors, very vibrant colors, because I wanted everything to be simplistic. And you can see here that it's quite different from how it looks now in the actual display, because a lot of the work was then done post on an iPad, essentially in Procreate, where I would sort of lay in some different colors and textures to create some of the patterns on the furs. Another favorite sort of series of illustrations that I worked on during this project would have been the whale evolution, which you can see behind me, some of the illustrations, and here's the Plexetus. What was really interesting to me, and I guess I just never had occurred to me, or I never really thought about it, was the fact that animals came out, you know, of the water, evolved, and then went back into the water. I never really thought of that idea of a mammal going back into the water to evolve, and to see the arms and the legs slowly turn into fins, and then eventually the legs just completely disappeared on some of the more recent whales. It was quite an interesting thing for me. As well as the work being featured here in the main gallery, the artwork itself is actually being featured in the Perspectives Gallery as well. And brought my family here today to come see it. I'm really excited to show them the work, especially because one of my kids was actually not even born at the time. And my daughter, Diana, was very, very young at the time. So for her to see it now, it's much different. She can really process it, and I'm really excited to show it to the two of them.